In this video, I will talk about the prisoner's dilemma, which is a two-person non-constant-sum game. A non-constant-sum game is a game for which the sum of the two players' payoffs is not always a constant value. Here is an example of the prisoner's dilemma. Two robbery suspects are arrested and imprisoned. They are interrogated simultaneously in separate rooms, so they cannot communicate with each other. The prosecutors lack sufficient evidence to convict them on the principal charge, but they do have the evidence against the suspects on a minor charge. The prosecutors offer each prisoner a bargain. This is a payoff matrix. Each prisoner is given the opportunity either to betray the partner by testifying that the other committed the crime, or to be loyal to the partner by remaining silent. If prisoner A and prisoner B each betray the other, each of them will serve 12 months in prison. If A betrays B but B remains loyal to the partner, A will be set free and B will serve 18 months in prison, and vice versa. If prisoners A and B are both loyal and remain silent, they will each only serve 3 months in prison on the minor charge. Suppose each suspect only wants to minimize their own punishment. What is the best strategy for each of them? Note that the first number in each cell of this matrix is the number of months in prison for A. The negative sign means this is undesirable punishment. The second number in each cell is the number of months in prison for B. The sum of the payoffs in each cell varies from a high of 24 months to a low of 6 months. Thus, this is a two-person non-constant sum game. Before we solve this problem, let's first see a new concept called dominated strategy. A strategy is dominated if, regardless of what the other player does, the strategy always earns a smaller payoff than some other strategy. In other words, a strategy is dominated if it is always better to play some other strategy. For this example, let's take a look at prisoner A's strategies, betray or be loyal. If B chooses betray, A should choose betray as well because he would serve 12 months in prison instead of 18 months. If B chooses loyal, A should still choose betray because he could serve 0 months in prison instead of 3 months. So betray is always a better strategy for A. Similarly, if A chooses betray, B should choose betray as well because she would serve 12 months in prison instead of 18 months. If A chooses loyal, B should still choose betray because she would serve 0 months in prison instead of 3 months. So betray is always a better strategy for B. Therefore, loyal is a dominated strategy for both prisoners. A player can eliminate all dominated strategies from consideration. After the elimination, they will end up in this betray-betray situation. We call this cell -12, -12 a Nash equilibrium, which means neither player can benefit from a unilateral change in strategy. The dilemma is that it is clear there is a better choice for the prisoners if they can communicate with each other and both decide to be loyal. They may each get just 3 months in prison instead of 12 months. However, this outcome may not occur in the prisoner's dilemma game because they are interrogated separately and cannot communicate with each other. This point is not an equilibrium point because they both would want to deviate from this point and get less punishment by changing the strategy from loyal to betray. And finally, the game ends up in the betray-betray situation. This is why this type of game is called the prisoner's dilemma. Thanks for watching.